Tinnitus is a condition that people actually complain about or notice. It's a word meaning ringing, and ringing for most people could be either a buzz in the ear, cricket sounds, whooshing sounds. Most people generally think that tinnitus happens with people that have some type of hearing loss or hearing disorder of some sort. Not always. We do see some people in here with normal hearing that have tinnitus issues, but it's more common among older individuals, and it does seem to increase with age, particularly after age 65. For some people, they can have pervasive tinnitus and, you know, very minimal hearing loss. But they're so focused on that tinnitus that it does affect their mood, anxiety, concentration, ability to sleep. There's a strong correlation between tinnitus and sleep, tinnitus and stress. And also, there's many medications that the side effect is tinnitus. There's certain things that make tinnitus worse. Something as common as middle ear pressure or fullness, that can, you know, some people, that can be a trigger for tinnitus. Earwax can cause tinnitus in some folks. The ENT will probably ask enough questions to figure out, or the nurse will figure out what things they're doing that might be causing the tinnitus, or things they can stop doing to alleviate the tinnitus. There isn't a cure, you know, pill-wise. And the best recommendation is counseling. Hearing aids, amplification is recommended for people that have tinnitus and hearing loss, and some type of noise therapy. And there's a lot of apps you can have people download now that they can use. Environmental noises, rain, water noises, to kind of help them to listen to something else and to forget about the tinnitus. Everybody's different, so there's not just one thing that you can do for everybody, and that's what makes helping people with tinnitus so challenging.